project. Can you do construct now? My name is Rehan. My friends Vedant, Yogit, Nidhi, and Joyna. Now we have to start our project. We discuss love animation. Everything from Marvel, Madagascar, my kids. But my mom is quite an animation fan. I know, right? Animation sounds much to a girl. How did this world even begin? We little curious kids wanted to explore further. So, we created our own animation device and produced our own movie with your help. So, now allow my friends to take you through the technical aspect of our contraption and help you understand it further. A movie is nothing but a picture. High speed, 24 frames per second per second. Azotrope is a cylinder with slots in its sides. When you place a strip of drawing in the zootrope drum and rotate it and see from the shot, you will see the images come to life. The slots prevent the images from blurring out and hence create an illusion of motion.
Before we begin our show, let us take you through the mechanism of the zootrope. Our aim was to spin the zootrope. Surely we can put an electric motor to make our job.
But where's the fun in that? So instead, we put our brains together to design a human-powered zootrope.
Okay. I'm asking our chief guest to say a few words from horse mouth. Okay, let it go.
Experience as a teacher, as a parent, as a builder and engineer, I've started several companies, that the answer to the real problem is not in the book. It's a problem you've never seen before. And the real power of projects like this is not that they teach the kids the things in the book, it's that you can learn the things that are not in the book, that are applying the things you've learned in school to something completely new. And that's what we're preparing our students for by doing projects like Science Fair, because they're being creative, they're creating something, they're taking what they learned in a school and applying it to something new. And that's what the real world's like. It's about taking things we learned one way and understanding them so much that we can solve another problem we've never seen before. That's powerful education, and that's what Science Fair is like.
Can you share with us details about today's events and that's a good initiative you have taken out today? Can you tell us about that?
Yeah. At the outset, I would like to express our gratitude and sincere thanks to the media, electronic media group, for having attended today's program in large numbers. Okay, this 8th NES International Science and Technology Festival 2019 has been arranged to see to it that the children are going away from the labs and classrooms to learn something anew from their mentors, from the teachers, and from their guests visited on the occasion. Okay, the students are well informed that science and technology will bring changes to the knowledge and to the world, individual knowledge and to the world at large. So knowing very well, the students have taken maximum interest along with their parents to put up the projects, now numbering around 287 projects are there, 447 students have taken part, and from students across the country and across South Asia, they also participated. There are 87 projects in that. As it appeared in the Times of India today, we have mentioned that the Government of India has given approval to take maximum help from the science institutes like IIT, BRC, and all. They also put up their stalls for the benefit of the viewers. Okay, what are the unique features? As Dr. Jayaraman said it, a periodic table of chemistry is a unique one. The UNO has recognized and declared that periodic table is very important, and this year 2019 should be treated as the year of the periodic table like that. So we took initiative to see to that before anybody observes and celebrates, we should do it like that. You know, on 12th January, we have started observing and celebrating the periodic table launching. Okay, for whole year we will be conducting the program, and in the next science festival, we will be conducting valedictory function. Okay, apart from that, the teacher side also, various seminars and workshops are conducted by these dignitaries for enabling the teachers to offer effective teaching in the classrooms. Okay, and parents have also taken interest. So teachers, students, mentors, and guests, they are all the stakeholders to enhance the knowledge of the students. Okay, and they are aware that, you know, the students are aware that they should go with the time and technology to acquire good future. As Sir Damsar said it, the future of the country and world lies in the hands and minds of the students. So we are preparing them accordingly.
So what kind of response you are getting from the parents?
Parents, they have come in large numbers. Okay. And they came to the classrooms to prepare the students, prepare the projects for the students, because we have not allowed outsourcing. They were buying the projects from outside. So this time we have prohibited that entry of those project, and we have made them to sit in the classroom and prepare. And therefore, what is presented today is the original idea of my students, mentors, and teachers. Okay, yeah.
You might want to say something about the original work. How important it was.
See, because it is an artificial intelligence area.
Yeah.
Everything is made indigenous.
Indigenous.
That is the key point.
So it is how much will be helpful for our children, this kind of practical you have taken this initiative. Do you think it will be helpful for much more than like the future as a career perspective?
Yeah. You see, research, the students become research minded. Hello, one of the students of class 1, first standard, say when the inspector visited the class from Australia, three inspectors were there. From Australia they visited for getting recognition for the primary section. They visited, they went to classroom 1. See, in the first group, they asked the question. They answered very well. Second group, one boy could not answer. You know, he did not say that he doesn't know the answer. He mentioned that, give me 2 minutes, ma'am, I'll give the answer. Well, how will you get it? You give me 2 minutes with that. He went ahead with the research work. In the meantime, the inspector moved on to the next group. So after completion of the grade 1, A, B, C, the inspector came back to the student and asked for the answer. He said the correct answer. Yeah. He said, how could you get the answer? I carried out research. So research plays very important role for the individual development and national development.
Yeah.
Okay?
Doctor,
it is a research finding.
Yeah.
Helps a lot for economic development also.
Yes.
Okay?
Dr. Aaron, you want to say,
yes.
Because if you can't make a development of this,
yeah.
it's just in the book.
Yeah.
Sir, I generally travel to many schools across the globe, and I do skill development in UAE as well as in many schools in India. But you know, even Atal Tinkering Labs, there are many number of Atal Tinkering Labs across India, around 4,000 Atal Tinkering Labs. But NES is going 1 mile extra to bring in experts like Professor Tom and myself and many other experts, APJ sir and many other experts. What we are trying to inculcate is to inculcate commercial research quality among school students. In school level itself, we are trying to mold them as an entrepreneur. Like I told about ATM projects, right? If I speak and teach more about ATM kind of projects, ATM conservation, power conservation projects, students themselves will come out another power conservation devices, which will make them even entrepreneur. And they will also be educated to make mobile applications like WhatsApp and other applications, wherein the users can use it daily, and which will make in turn the students rich. That is also the area which we are working into.
Importing skill development right from grade 3. Year-wise, we'll be introducing. There is already syllabus already designed and delivered to us. We are going to implement that syllabus.
Electronics, automation, robotics, Internet of Things, artificial intelligence, and slowly we'll be moving to physical web. And from year 2 on, we will be moving to blockchain technologies also. So we are going to do a full-fledged skill development. Apart from that, we will also establish NES Innovation Center shortly, from which the skill development will contribute to more innovative projects, student projects.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Do you not think it will be helpful for education purpose, such as skill development and other activities? What is your thoughts on that?
Yeah, I think good education is about experiential learning and authentic learning. So when they learn through projects, and when they learn through these kinds of exhibition and experiments, what you're basically doing is telling them, teaching them to, you know, do and learn. And there's no better way than doing that. And of course, it's developing thinking skills more than just the content. It's not the content which is that important as building in the research skills, building in the idea of an inquiring mind, and which will remain with him for all his life. And the child will become a lifelong learner. I think that's a beauty of such a thing. It's not just an exhibition or a festival, but it is a festival of critical thinking, of innovation, of scientific temper. And how do you build that kind of thinking. I think that's good education. That's it? Tell me.
School also taking a providing as a job, but this school is taking an initiative to build an entrepreneur. Do you not think it's a very good start by the school are doing, building an entrepreneur as a student?
Yes, it's actually building a technocrat. Right? It's actually building a technocrat and a techno entrepreneur, and I think that's great, because entrepreneur means taking risks and building the initiative and innovation. From an invention to an innovation, entrepreneurship is required, and I think that's important. Welcome.
Science is a topic, a very hard, sober topic for students to study. We celebrate science. We have made it a science celebration as a festival. Special interest in this is 2019 is declared as the International Year of the Periodic Table, and the United Nations is launching it on 29th January. So we decided that in order to promote science, so that the dissemination of science and the diffusion of scientific knowledge on the periodic table should be launched by us. We have written a book. We are called We Are 118. There are 118 elements in the periodic table. Each element comes out as a student. And he stands up and says, I am hydrogen, hello, these are my properties, this is what I can do for you. The future belongs to me, the hydrogen economy. And similarly, the last element, organisation, which is the 118th element, is not known to many people. So our main business is to bring highlight the periodic table in all its glory, and to make the student community, to make it a part and a very strong part of our curriculum. That's our main objective here. We have also designed these science exhibits in such a way that the finest latent innate talent of the students are brought in, rather than it is being copied or taken out from Wikipedia. The originality, the innovation, and the creativity of the students are exposed here in the best possible manner.
There are also various projects. You can just give examples of these working models.
Oh, yeah. We have working models on membranes. Membranes are, the future belongs to water. Water has several problems. We have dirty water, grey water, black water, all sorts of, there are 118 types of waters over there. How to make it portable, safe water for our daily use, that, and for our industry, that has been a great challenge. The greatest challenge is managing water for the future. So we have a number of technologies developed, shown here. They are not developed by the students, but students have absorbed the concept and they have demonstrated it, that how a membrane, semi-permeable membrane takes it out, and what are the different types of membranes, so what are the properties you get from that, those are explained by students. Then in the field of electronics, the solar energy is the main thing for them. How do they design their solar cells and how do they get a right output from them? That's one aspect. Apart from that, the fundamental aspects of science, the basic physics, that is something which is lost in the syllabus. So students have been working with such simple but extremely elegant abstract concepts like electromagnetism. All these things are demonstrated here. And the teachers have been trained by scientists earlier. This exhibition has a large background behind it. We have trained and tutored the teachers first by working scientists. So from the scientists, through the teachers, to the students. That is the arrangement we have already. Thank you.